to their attention, dirty. That's
you better watch who you're talking about, running your mouth. Like
Henry Sibley fans fired up for the Warriors game against Woodbury. Luis Fernandez with a nice rope from the corner. He nails the three-pointer and Sibley takes an 8-point lead. Then in transition, Peter Leslie pushes it ahead to Noah Kaiser, who glides and scores with a finger roll. And this time Leslie does it all himself. The drive, and he hits the floater in the lane. Henry Sibley wins 76-57 the final. They'll face Creighton Tuesday night in the section final.
You know me, you gon' fuck around and show why to show me, get caught and show me why.
In the Section 4 4A Finals, it was Creighton taking on Henry Sibley. The Raiders get some help thanks to Torres Tillman. He cans the long three, giving Creighton a 1-point lead. But that didn't last long. The Warriors' Noah Kaiser drives in for the layup, and Sibley regains the lead by one. In the second half, Sibley takes a commanding lead. Mike Rusewicz drives hard to the hole for the slam. Warriors up by six, but Creighton's Michael Floyd had a big game himself. He hits the jumper and draws the foul. Raiders trail late by one, and with just seconds left, Floyd tries to tie the game, but it's no good. Henry Sibley is headed to state for the first time ever, 60-57 the final.
One-on-one, you can't hold me if your last name was Haynes. Only way you word me out is stitch my name on your pants. No resident of France, but you swear I'm from Paris. 106 carats, total, no, that's courage. Trying to get purpose, my chain to your chain. Like Sprint or Motorola, no service out of your range. You're out of your brain, thinking I'ma shout out your name. You gotta come up with better ways and actions to get your aim. All that pressure you were blind, it's time to ease off. Before I hit you from the blind side, taking your sleeves off. As much as we lost, still hard to please, boss. Don't be lying, crying, suck at the best of loss. Cause your axe is whack, your whole label is whack. Matter of fact, I hold that. I am number one, no matter if you like it, retake it, sit down and write it. I am number one. Now let me ask you, man, what does it take to be number one? Two is not a winner, and three, nobody remembers. What does it take to be number one? What I think he said, squash that. Probably got that off eBay or some internet access, some website chat line. Mad cause I got mine. Oh, don't wind up on a flat line. Oh, my uncle could see me now. If he could see how many rappers wanna be me now. Straight emulating my style, right to the downtown. Can't leave out the store now. Better wait till they calm down. I got hella shorties coming asking you where to party. Oh lordy, will I continue to act naughty? Mix it, Chris and Bacardi. Got me thinking for sure. I'm not a man of many words, but it's one thing I know.
If it's possible to be the surprise of the tournament and the number two seed, Henry Sibley has pulled it off. It's not because of a bad record or a lack of skill, but because this will be the first time in school history the Warriors have made the boys' state basketball tournament.
I think we are kind of a new team on the scene, and we're trying to be thought of as one of those teams that's perennially a top 10 program in the state.
They were ranked fifth this year with good reason. Henry Sibley lost just five games this year, beat Creighton-Durham Hall for a section championship, and won their first conference title in 35 years.
No, it hasn't really sunk in yet. Like, it was amazing when it happened and everything, but you don't really think about it that you're the only team here in I don't know how many years.
Man, I can't even describe how I felt after that game. I was so happy. I was ecstatic.
But not ecstatic enough to give the Warriors the idea that the battle is even close to over.
I feel like we're happy to be here, but you know, it's a business trip now. It's getting down to business. I mean, we feel like we have a really, really good shot to get into the state championship game, if not winning it.
With seven players 6'5 or taller, the Warriors are one of the tallest teams in the state. And because of it, their game plan is simple. Use that height to their advantage.
Well, we try to be really physical. We try to rebound the basketball well. This time of year, it becomes possession by possession type game.
Their big guys are really good, but we got big guys who guard them, so hopefully we can shut them down
and finish off the year of firsts at Henry Sibley with a state championship.
Judging what's real hip-hop half the time. Beat them to album flop. You know, boat done sank and it ain't left the dock. Come on, mad cause I'm hot. He just mad cause he not. You ain't gotta give me my props, just give me the yachts. Give me my rocks and keep my fans coming in flocks. Till you top the Super Bowl, keep your mouth on lock. see a new light at the top of the roof.
4A semifinal, Cooper took on Henry Sibley, making their first trip to state. Near the end of the first half, Sibley's Mike Brucewicz scores on the putback off his own missed free throw. He scored 18 points and pulled down 16 boards. Sibley led by 10 at the break, but Cooper storms back. An amazing alley-oop pass from Quincy Bethea to Rodney Williams Jr., who throws it down. The top play of the tournament so far. But the roller coaster continues. Tied at 41, Peter Leslie with a big three-pointer from the corner. Warriors back on top by three, then the icing on the cake. Brucewicz with the dunk, and Henry Sibley reaches the title game, 68-52 to final.
One of my senior forwards, Marcus Garcia, big number 55, came off the bench and really started catching and running the floor. He's got great feet, he's got soft hands, started finishing up everything and really getting on the offensive boards. I think he kind of sparked our momentum and really everybody got involved.
They're one of five high school basketball teams to make it to the state tournament for the very first time.
And the first time's been a charm for the Henry Sibley Warriors. They won a spot in Saturday's championship game. Proud alum Darcy Pollan shows us how they got there.
Classes were canceled today at Sibley High School to give students a chance to see history made.
This week has just been absolutely wild. The kids, the team, the teachers have been so excited. This is the first time we have ever gone to state in basketball.
The enthusiasm built before yesterday's game.
I'm really happy to be here. I mean, we're really excited. We're about ready to play. I kind of wish it was 2 o'clock right now, tip off.
I'm really jittery, excited. Just kind of jumping around lately. I can't. It's hard to sleep, hard to stay in one spot. You just can't wait to get on the floor.
First thing, guys.
But before that, a pep talk from Coach Dashkovitz.
You're going to remember it for the rest of your lives. You're going to be talking about this in 20, 30, 40 years. Clean up here. Let's go.
1, 2, 3.
The Henry Sibley Warriors.
A couple years ago, our fans didn't have many fans at the games. They have about 40 fans, and now they just took it to another level. That's just a great feeling right now. You got work to do still. I mean, you're not there yet.
Basketball has really taken over.
Nearly the entire student body scrambled to fill the stands today. A wave of momentum swept through the crowd. And they watched the Warriors move on to the finals on their very first trip to state.
Sibley has advanced to the state title game.
Baby, it ain't not single, but I speak the truth. I heat the booth, belly acting so uncouth. Top down, shirt off in the coupe, spreading the loot with my family and friends and my closest of kin. And I do it again. I'ma win.
After a big Sibley lead, the momentum completely shifts on this sequence. Henry Sibley turns the ball over, C.J. Erickson coast to coast for the jam, and while he's running back down the court, Chomper steals the inbounds pass. Anthony Tucker hits another 3-point to give the Skippers a 1-point lead. Minutes later, they swing over to Burns. He hits another triple to cap off a 36-9 minute Tonka run. The Skippers come back from a 22-point deficit, and they are the Class 4A state champs after a 68-59 victory.
Number one, yeah, yeah, yeah. I, number one. Two is not a winner, and three nobody remembers. Number one, because two is not a winner.